everyone, welcome to physics online classes for class 11 students. Let us continue chapter 2, units and measurement. So before going to continue this chapter, we can revise quickly what we have studied in the previous classes. You can remember we studied about physical quantity, which can be expressed in terms of numbers or numerical value. There are two types of physical quantity, and they are fundamental quantity and derived quantity. Then after that, we studied about the system of units. There are three systems of unit in the earlier days, and they are CGS system, FPS system and MKS system. CGS system indicates length, mass and time. They are going to express in terms of centimeter, gram and second. Similarly, in FPS system, we are going to express in terms of foot, pound and second. And in the third one, MKS system, we are going to express meter, kg and second. So these are the three system of units. Later, one more system of unit is added, and that is international system of unit. In short, we can call it as SI unit. SI unit means what? International system of unit. In international system of unit, totally, there are 7 fundamental units and 2 supplementary units. Which are the 7 fundamental units? They are length, mass, time, current, temperature, luminous intensity and amount of substance. These are the 7 fundamental units. And the 2 supplementary units are plane angle and solid angle. Now you have the question like why the SI system is having separate supplementary units, or why plane angle and solid angle are called as supplementary units. Only the answer is plane angle, solid angle, these two are related to geometry. These two terms are not having any dimensions. They are dimensionless. That means, I will give you one simple example. What is the SI unit of velocity? Velocity is expressed in terms of meter per second. Meter per second is what? Derived quantity. Because second is the fundamental quantity. Meter per second. Another example I will give you. So you are going to study later. That is angular velocity. The SI unit of angular velocity is radian per second. What is the SI unit of angular velocity? Radian per second. Here, in that radian per second, second is the fundamental quantity. Radian, it is neither fundamental nor derived. It is completely related to geometry. Right? So that's why plane angle, solid angle, they are expressed in terms of radian and steradian. Radian, steradian, these two are neither fundamental nor derived. They are completely related to, they are purely geometrical. So that's why plane angle and solid angle, we are going to take them as supplementary physical quantities. And also we studied the definitions of all the fundamental quantities and supplementary quantities. That means from length to solid angle, we defined all the terms. Right? So this is what we have studied in the previous classes. Again, I am going to continue international system of unit. That is SI unit. What are the rules we have to follow to write the SI unit? That we can study in the today's session. Now let us start the class. So rules for writing of symbols in SI. SI means what? International system. In international system, what rules we have to follow for writing the symbols? There are totally 5 rules we have to follow when you are going to write the symbols of SI system. The first rule is, you can read the first rule. The symbol of a unit named after a person is written in capital letters. For example, Newton is the SI unit of force. What is the SI unit of force? Newton. How to write Newton? That is very important. That is the first rule. What is the first rule? The symbol of a unit named after a person is written in capital letters. So Newton is the physicist or the scientist name. Isaac Newton, we already know it. So Newton, it is the SI unit of force. If you are going to write Newton like this, first letter is capital and remaining all are small letters. So this indicates name of the scientist. This is what name of the scientist. But we want unit of the force. How to write the SI unit? See here, we have to write capital N, or we can write simply all the alphabets in the small letters. So this is the SI unit of force. Is it clear? This is the first rule. The symbol of a unit named after a person is written in capital letters. So that means you can write N for Newton, J for Joule, or you can take Ampere. Ampere is the scientist name. So here, when we are going to write the SI unit of current, SI unit of current means I can write simply as A. Capital A is the SI unit of current. Come to the second rule. The full name of the unit named after a person is written in small letters. A force of 1 newton, a work of 1 joule. Sometimes in your board examination, they may ask to define 1 newton. Define 1 newton. So that time you have to write the complete name. This is also unit of force. See here, either you can write capital N or you can write small letters, complete name, that is Newton. These are the first two rules for writing the symbols in SI system. Is it clear? The first rule is the symbol of a unit named after a person is written in capital letters. For example, N for Newton, J for Joule. Joule is the SI unit of what? Work. So work is expressed in terms of joule. So you have to write capital J here. Then Newton is the SI unit of force. So here you can write capital N. Then second rule is the full name of the unit named after a person is written in small letters. That means when you are going to write 1 newton, 1 joule, 10 ampere. So that time you have to write the complete name, but remember all the letters should be in small. If you are going to write capital N and remaining all are small letters, then it is completely wrong. So this indicates name of the scientist. When you are going to write the unit, either you can use capital N or all the letters should be in small. Then come to third rule. The symbol of a unit should be written either in full form or in agreed short form. When you are going to write unit of any physical quantity, so you can use either the full form or in the agreed short form. That means, now I am going to write the SI unit of length. What is the SI unit of length? Either I can write its full form, that is meter, or we can write unit in short form, that is simply M. For example, length of the rod, I can take it as length of the rod is 20 meter. Or we can take it as 20 meter. Complete letter we have to write, or simply it's a short form. Similarly, mass. So the unit or the symbol of a unit for mass, either you can write as a kilogram completely, or simply you can write kg. Then come to the third one, time. So the unit of time, SI unit of time is second. Complete letters we have to write second, or simply you can write S. Don't write SEC. If you are going to write simply SEC, then it is completely wrong. It is not the SI unit. Either you can write S or you can write complete the full form of that unit. So this is third rule. The symbol of a unit should be written either in the full form or in the agreed short form. Come to the fourth rule. Units and their symbols should not be written in plural forms. Remember, don't write SI unit in the plural form. Plural means what? More than one. For example, meter should not be written as meters. Don't write 2 meters, 10 meters, 100 meters. Don't express SI unit in plural form. It is completely wrong. Then another example you can observe here. Kg should not be written as kgs. It is completely wrong. Kgs, meters, seconds. Sometimes you use the word 2 seconds. 2 seconds is wrong. We have to write simply second. 2 second. Amperes. It is wrong. Kelvins. It is wrong. So, we should not write SI unit in plural forms. This is the fourth rule. So, which is the fourth rule? Units and their symbols should not be written in plural forms. Then, come to the last rule for writing the symbols in SI. That is, the symbol of derived unit is written with negative indices. The symbol of derived unit. So, you can observe this tabular column. Speed, density, acceleration, these all are derived unit. Is it clear? So, the symbol of derived unit is written with negative indices. Because derived quantities are expressed in terms of fundamental quantity. You can observe speed unit is meter per second. So, we are expressing their indices in negative form. You can observe meter per second. S raised to minus 1. This minus 1 is what? Negative indices. Or the power in terms of negative. Then come to density. The SI unit of density is kg per meter cube. M raised to minus 3. This is what? Negative power. Acceleration is expressed in SI system as meter per second square. Here minus 2 is what? Negative power. So, the symbol of derived unit is written with negative indices. So, these are the 5 rules for writing symbols in SI. Now, can you tell me which are the 5 rules for writing the symbols? The first rule, the symbol of a unit named after a person is written in capital letters. Second rule, the full name of unit named after a person is written in small letters. Come to the third rule. The symbol of a unit should be written either in full form or in the agreed short form. Then fourth rule is units and their symbols should not be written in the plural form. Last rule, the symbol of derived unit is written with negative indices. So these are the 5 rules to write the symbols in international system of unit. Now we can move to the next part, that is coherent system of unit. Remember, SI unit, that is international system of unit, is also called as coherent system of unit. SI unit is also called as coherent system of unit. What do you mean by coherent? First, we have to know the meaning of coherent. Coherent means fixed relationship. Here, there is a fixed relationship between fundamental and derived quantity because derived quantities are expressed with the help of fundamental quantity. So, that's why SI unit is also called as coherent system of unit. Then, how to define coherent system of unit? You can observe the definition here. A system of unit in which the units of all physical quantities, the units of all physical quantities can be obtained from fundamental units by simple multiplication or division without introducing any numerical factor. that is called coherent system of unit. For example, I am going to consider one physical quantity like a velocity. Velocity is a physical quantity because we can express velocity in terms of numbers. Velocity equal to 10. What is its unit? The SI unit of velocity is meter per second. Now you can observe the unit of this velocity. So this unit can be obtained from fundamental units. Fundamental unit is second. Meter is also fundamental unit or fundamental quantities. So we are obtaining the units from fundamental units by simple multiplication or division. Here it is division, 10 meter per second. So by simple multiplication or sometimes by simple division, we are obtaining the unit from fundamental quantities. Here we are not using any number, any numerical factor. Simply we are using fundamental units by multiplying or by dividing. So this is called coherent system of unit. SI unit is also called as coherent system of unit because all the physical quantities can be obtained from fundamental units by simple multiplication or division. For example, there is a term like impulse or impulsive force. You are going to study in Newton's laws of motion. Impulsive force or impulse, this is the large amount of force acting on a body in a short interval of time. I am going to hit the ball with the help of a bat. When you hit the ball, you are applying large force on the ball with the help of a bat in a short interval of time. Within a short interval of time, when we applied large force, then we can call it as impulsive force or impulse. Impulse is given by the expression force into time. This is the expression for impulse that you are going to study later. Now you can observe only the equation. Force into time is called impulse. Now tell me, what is the SI unit of impulse? Force is expressed in terms of Newton. Time is expressed in terms of second. So Newton second is the SI unit of impulse. Now second is a fundamental quantity that we are using here. Here we are using simple multiplication. Newton into second. Newton second. In velocity, we used second and meter from fundamental quantity, but here we are using simple division. Either by using simple multiplication or division, we are obtaining from fundamental units, so we are going to call it as coherent system of unit. Now tell me, what is a coherent system of unit? A system of unit in which the unit of all physical quantities can be obtained from fundamental units by simple multiplication or division without introducing any numerical factor. So this is called coherent system of unit, which is also called as SI unit, that is international system of unit. Come to the next term, rational system of unit. What is that rational system of unit? A system in which all the physical quantities are expressed in one unit. We are not using more than one unit in the SI system. So we are going to call it as a rational system of unit. You can understand by taking the below example. In MKS system, what do you mean by MKS? Meter, kilogram and second. That is the third system of unit. In MKS system, the unit of energy is joule in mechanics. Mechanics is the branch of physics which deals with the study of moving bodies. That is mechanics. In mechanics, what is the unit of energy? Joule. But here you can take calorie. Calorie is also the unit of energy when we are studied in thermodynamics, like a heat. Thermodynamics is the branch of physics which deals with the study of heat and temperature. There, instead of joule, I am using the unit calorie. So, in electricity, electricity is the branch of physics which deals with the study of current, electric field, magnetic field, flow of charges. So, in that branch, the unit of energy is watt hour. Now, you can observe, there are different units for energy. In mechanics, we can use joule. In thermodynamics, we can use calorie. In electricity, we can use watt hour for energy. There are different units in MKS system. But in SI system, we have to use only one unit. Now you can observe. Therefore, MKS system is not rational. Rational means what? We should express only in one unit. All the physical quantities are expressed in one unit, then we can call it as a rational system of unit. Here, MKS system is not a rational system because in MKS, we have different unit for the same physical quantity. But in SI system, in international system of unit, all types of energy is expressed in joule. That may be mechanics branch or electricity or thermodynamics. In any branch, you can consider the SI unit of energy is only joule. Right? There is no different unit. Hence, SI is a rational system of unit. Remember, students, in SI system, SI unit is also called as coherent system or it is also called as rational system. So, why we are going to call SI as a coherent system? Because in coherent, all the physical quantities can be obtained from fundamental units by using simple multiplication and division. And the same SI unit is also called as rational system of unit because all the physical quantities are expressed in one unit. For example, energy. The SI unit of all types of energy is joule in SI system. Hence, SI is a rational system of unit. MKS system is not rational because in MKS system, energy, all types of energies are having different units. So that's why in SI system, we are using only one unit. So SI system is a rational system of unit. Now we can study about prefixes in SI. Prefix, suffix and prefix we have studied in the English subject. Prefixes, before the word we have to use. Suffix, after the word. Before and after. Prefix, pre means before. You can understand prefixes in SI by observing this tabular column. So, in this tabular column, there is a submultiples and multiples. In the submultiples, again, there are three columns. The first column is about prefix, second column indicates a factor, third column indicates symbol. Prefix, you can observe the first column. Deci, centi, milli, micro, nano, pico, femto, atto. So, these are the prefix. Decimal, centimeter, milliameter, microfarad, nanometer, picofarad, femtometer, attometer. So, these words we can use before the units. Right? Deci, centi, milli, micro, nano, pico, femto, atto. These are the prefix for submultiples. Then deci means what? Factor means that number should be multiplied by 10 raised to minus 1. Centi, 10 raised to minus 2. Milli, 10 raised to minus 3. Micro, 10 raised to minus 6. Nano, 10 raised to minus 9. Pico, 10 raised to minus 12. Femto, 10 raised to minus 15. Atto, 10 raised to minus 18. Remember, in physics, while solving numerical problems, sometimes the givens are in terms of micro, in terms of nano, in terms of atto. While calculating those values, you should know their factors. Pico means how much? Pico, 10 raised to minus 12. For example, capacitance of a capacitor. Capacitance of a capacitor. About capacitor, you are going to study in PUC second year. Now, listen here. Capacitance of a capacitor, it is given. C equal to 2 pico farad. Farad is its unit. I wrote here 2 pico farad. Now, C equal to 2 pico farad can be written as 2 into pico means how much? 10 raised to minus 12 farad. In this way, we have to write. Right? So, these are the prefixes. So, instead of writing deci, we can use the symbol D. For centi, we can use C. For milli, we can use M. For micro, this is the symbol. We have to write like this. This is micro. So, I will give you one more example. So, length of the rod is given. L equal to 10 micrometer. 10 micrometer means what? L equal to 10 into micro means how much? 10 into 10 raised to minus 6 meter. Then, nano can be written as small n. The symbol of pico is P, femto is F, and atto is A. So, these are the prefix we have to use for submultiples. Then come to the multiples. Here, we can write these all are in terms of negative prefix. So, for multiples, the prefix we can use deca, hecta, kilo, mega, giga, tera, peta, exa. So, the power you can observe here, the indices all are in positive. In submultiples, all are in negative. Deca is having the factor 10 raised to 1, hecta 10 raised to 2, kilo 10 raised to 3, mega 10 raised to 6, giga 10 raised to 9, tera 10 raised to 12, peta 10 raised to 15, exa 10 raised to 18. Or we can use the symbols for deca is DA. For hecta, we can use H. For kilo, we can use K. For mega, I can write capital M. For giga, capital G. For tera, capital T. For peta, capital P. For exa, we can use capital E. These are the symbols for prefix in the multiples. So, this is submultiples. You can compare both the tabular columns, submultiples and multiples. See here, deci 10 raised to minus 1, deca 10 raised to plus 1, centi 10 raised to minus 2, hecta 10 raised to plus 2, milli 10 raised to minus 3, kilo 10 raised to plus 3, micro 10 raised to minus 6, mega 10 raised to plus 6, nano 10 raised to minus 9, giga 10 raised to plus 9. Pico 10 raised to minus 12. Terra 10 raised to plus 12. Femto 10 raised to minus 15. Peta that is 10 raised to plus 15. And at last atto that is 10 raised to minus 18. Exa 10 raised to plus 18. So these are the prefixes we have to use in the international system of unit for submultiples as well as multiples. So, now we can study the advantages of SI, International System of Unit. Their advantages or applications or merits of SI we can study now. The first advantage of SI is, it is a rational system of unit because only one unit is used for a given physical quantity as we have studied the different types of energy. So, for all the types of energy, they are using the SI unit is joule. That may be mechanics or thermodynamics or electricity. Only one unit we are using. So, this is the advantage of SI. So, it is a rational system of unit. Come to the second point. It is a coherent system of unit. So, why SI is a coherent system of unit? Because all the derived units can be obtained from fundamental and supplementary units without using any numerical factors, just by simple multiplication and division, we are obtaining all the units from fundamental and supplementaries. So SI is a coherent system of unit. This is also advantage. Come to the third point. It is closely related to CCS system, because SI units can be easily converted into CCS system. For example, length of a rod is equal to 10 centimeter. Centimeter is a CCS unit. We can easily convert it into SI system. How to convert 10 centimeter to meter? We know that 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter, or we can write it as 1 meter equal to 100 means I can write it as a 10 raised to 2 centimeter. But here I have to convert from centimeter to meter. So we can write 10 centimeter means 10 into 10 raised to minus 2 meter. Is it clear? So in this way, easily we can convert CCS system to SI system. So it is closely related to CCS system. Come to the fourth advantage. It is a metric system because multiples and submultiples can be expressed as the power of 10. So we studied prefixes used in the SI system. That is what metric system. Metric system means what? Multiples and submultiples can be easily expressed in terms of power of 10. That is, length L equal to, I can write 10 nanometer. 10 nanometer. Nano means how much? This is a submultiple. Nano is equal to 10 raised to minus 9 meter. So in metric system, multiples and submultiples can be easily expressed as the power of 10. So these are the some advantages of international system of unit. So in today's session, we studied the 5 rules to write the symbols in the international system of unit. We defined a coherent system of unit, a rational system of unit, and prefixes in international system of unit. And at last, we studied advantages of international system of unit. This completes the system of units. In the next session, we can learn measurement of length. Thank you.